So my advice, like I always tell with people that, like in Vinh now have a lot of free English club, right? Like Hello English Club in the, like today morning, like Tuesday morning, every week, on Thursday night, Up English Club, Friday night, Vinh English Club, on Lim Coffee, yeah, and Sunday afternoon at No Coffee is, what is it called?
English Club Vinh.
Yeah, No Coffee, English Club or something, but around like 4 or 5 free English club right now, right? And you can go there. It's much better for you to speak in English, like a lot. Like only way to get you improve English, the real way is by listening a lot and speaking a lot, like practice, keep practice every single day. And you will getting better every single time, right? It's just like the first time when you go on the stage to talk with a lot of people, you will feel really shy and maybe shaking, and you have to spend a lot of time to preparing. But after one time and some more time, you will more confident, right? And you understand how to talk, like you learned every single time you go on the stage and talk in front of people. It's just like English. The more time you're speaking in English is the more time you like, the more English that you're going to get. And use internet. It's free. It's huge. A lot of apps, right? Website, learning English. Check SeanLawrence.com. I know I'm his wife. That website is free. It's good, right? We always trying to people like learn English the right way. Like you save money. And you like study English is not like you spend a lot of money, go to English center and a lot of teacher and you will getting better. No. I always tell with my students, hey look, if you spend like 3 or 4 times a week study at your teacher's house, go to English centers to studying English, you keep doing that, but at home you not practice, you cannot better at one student. They not go anywhere, they pay zero to study English, they just stay at home, they listening to English, speak it, right? They keep every day they write one topic, like or listening to music, watch TV shows like Ellen show and many other shows on TV and YouTube. It's free and it's really funny. I learn a lot of stuff. Yeah, and one thing is you can listening to music, right? And have an app called Lyric Training, and you can check it out. It have TV shows, movies, and songs that you can listen and enjoy and study at the same time. When I was in high school, or I always learn every single new words my teacher told me, because I always worry that my teacher going to pick me, right? To ask for the homework, and I always learn that. So I like it. I think it's really important when the teacher gave you the new words and you keep practice and learn it. And one way how to remember those new words is you can make the stories or make sentences using those words. And you can remember a lot the words that is new for you. And you can like practice, like use Google Translate or T-flat dictionary, and you can check it, like use and you sing it over and over, you have fun and you learn English at the same time. Or you can watch a movie with in English the whole time, right? And you can you can put the Vietnamese subtitle and try it for a month. And after that, you can change the subtitles into English. right? And it works. And when you try it for a few more months, you feel, okay, I can understand a little bit, and you can watch a English movies without the subtitles. Yeah, like what I did right now, like Sean helped me a lot with that. Other one way you can getting better at English is teaching someone. Right, when you teach your brothers or sisters, right, you can study by doing that. Always practice.
That is some excellent advice and a lot of really good information for anyone that is learning English. I'm going to continue asking my wife some questions. One of the things she recommended was listening to songs in English. And it's a great game that you can play. You can use your computer or you can use an app on your phone. And the name of the app is lyricstraining.com. Or Lyrics Training is the name of the app. And then you can download it from their website at lyricstraining.com. I put a link in the chat, so just look through the chat and you'll see the link there. So Wendy,
yes.
Can you think of some more apps that students can use to get better at English? It could be an app or it could be a website.
So one app I think is really good. Like it's free, okay? It's free, no money. One is Duolingo. You can set up for 10 minutes a day or 15 minutes a day. You can practice about grammar. Yeah, grammar and new words.
Everyday things, yeah. In everyday life.
Yeah, it have everything in there. Like 25 levels or something. It's really, really good. The first is that very easy, and you can feel, oh, it's too boring for me, you know. But no, keep going. You will learn a lot of stuff in there, and it's really help you with new words and grammar and everything. And the second app, I think, with the it's good.
So Duolingo is really, really good. I'm gonna put the link in the chat, but Duolingo learns how you learn. So the more questions that you answer, the better that it knows about you. And so it will actually change the questions that you're answering in the future depending on the questions that you've answered in the past. And that's how, it's one of the ways that it learns how you're learning the language. So like Wendy said, it starts easy, but then it gets better for you and for your level. Not really, really hard, but just hard enough to make you kind of think more about your answers. And I will put a link in the chat. And Wendy is going to talk about the second app for learning English now.
Okay, the second app I want to introduce for you is Revit. It has 3,000 stories. And just like in a lot of different topics, like history, geography, communication, many different topics, like 10 or 12 topics. And every day you can just read one story, one day. You can type in that and it can like talk to you and you can repeat after it. Be careful with your pronunciation. Yes, it can, like, you tap one word and you hold it. And the phone can listen to your pronunciation. If you are right, it will make a yay! The hoo-hoo or something like the firework.
Yeah.
But if your pronunciation is not correct, it will make a red color.
Yeah.
And you have to try it again. And try it, like, believe me, before my pronunciation, I make a lot of mistakes, a lot of it. And it's really need to practice. Like my brother, his pronunciation is like awful. Yeah, almost every single word he said is wrong. They are wrong. But you know what? After 2 years, he practiced every day, and he wake up, the minute he wake up, he listen to English. He talk with foreigners. He go out to talk, go every English clubs to talk with friends, even Vietnamese. Who cares, right? A lot of Vietnamese people, they speak English really good right now, and you can go and talk with them. Yeah, and you know what? Last month, he got the IELTS speaking 7.7. I'm so surprised. I'm so happy. Like, wow, 7 in the IELTS. I think it's really, really successful for him. And his English is so much better. Like before, he just said English. No, wrong. English, right? So a lot of people, they got wrong with that. Even the number 5, they say 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, no? Yeah, but it's like some words, like some number, like number 5, 6, 8, 9, 12, right? A lot of people make that simple mistake, like something like that. It's simple, but it's really important, and you use it a lot. And when you make it wrong, when you study wrong in the first time, you keep repeat it in the wrong time. It take forever, and it take like years to fix it, break that thing, and fix it, and like learn the new right way. And it take a while. Mm-hmm.